Hello friends, welcome once again to my next video tutorial on Java for beginners. In this video, we will see what is an interface and how we can use interface in Java. As I told in my last video, interface is the another way to achieve abstraction in Java. So, what is an interface? An interface is a reference type in Java. It is a blueprint of a class. An interface contains only constants and abstract methods. In interface, the Java compiler adds by default public, static, and final keyword before the data members and public abstract keyword before the interface method. Okay. Interface also cannot be instantiated like abstract classes. But as I told, an interface contains only abstract methods, means incomplete methods. So, it is not possible to create an object to an interface. In this case, we can create separate classes where we can implement all the methods of the interfaces. So, these classes are called implementation classes, right? Interface is more useful when compared to the classes, because every implementation class can have its own implementation of the abstract methods of the interface. Okay. And we can create new interface like new classes in Eclipse. So in Eclipse, we can make interface by just going to the package in which our main class is present or our main method is present, and here just right click it and we can go to new and then click interface here. After that, we can give the name to our interface. For example, in my case, I am going to give the name to our interface as shapes and then click on finish. So we can see here, this is the basic definition of interface is created, and whatever method you define inside the interface like area, it is automatically abstract by nature. Okay, to understand better, let us take an example. So here we have a same shape class, which is our super class, and we have defined this class as an abstract class. So this class cannot be instantiated. Okay. Now, in place of doing so many things like declaring abstract keyword here before class and inside class, we need to declare abstract before method for incomplete methods. If we just write a keyword called public interface here, then it becomes interface and all the method inside an interface are abstract by default. Means we don't need to add a keyword abstract in any member method of the interface like this. As I told you earlier, all the methods of the interface are public and abstract by default. And all the data members are public, static, and final by default. Okay, in case of abstract class, we have seen if methods are abstract, then we need to implement this in the extended subclass in which we are inheriting. But in case of interference, whenever we want to inherit from the interface, then interface only can be implemented, not can be extended, as we were doing in a class. Understood? We are implementing, not extending, right? Means whenever we want to inherit from the interface, there is no class keyword in the shape interface, right? So we cannot extend from an interface into a class, and we need to implement the interface. Understood? So we need to use the keyword implement something like this. Okay. And we have this area method inside our interface. We need to define or give the definition of this area method in our subclass, because all the methods inside our interface are abstract by default. So we need to give definition something like this in the implemented class. So here this method is just return the area of rectangle. Okay, understood? So whenever we want to inherit from the interface, we use the keyword implement rather than extend. Understood? Okay. And whenever we want to inherit from the interface to an interface, we can use the keyword extend. If we have two classes, class 1 and class 2, and class 2 inherits from class 1, then we can use extend keyword. Okay. So simple rule is, class extends another class and interface extends another interface, but a class implements an interface. Understood? All right. So this is how we can use interface in Java. Okay, now based on this discussion, let us discuss some important points of interface. By interface, we can support the functionality of multiple inheritance. Means a class can implement multiple interfaces, like class, this is my class name, my class, and it is implementing interface 1 and interface 2. Okay, an interface contains only abstract methods, which are all incomplete methods. We cannot create an object to an interface, but we can create a reference of the interface type. All the methods of the interface should be implemented in its implementation class. If any method is not implemented, then that implementation class should be declared as abstract. Okay, we can use only constant variables inside a interface, no instance variables. And the last and important point is, interface is slow when we compare to abstract classes, because in case of interface, every time a method is called, then JVM start search for that method in the implementation classes, which are installed so many different places in the system. And after searching, it will execute those methods. So this will take more time. Understood? But when an abstract class is written, since abstract class having common methods which are defined within the abstract class and subclasses in which we are defining our methods are generally in the same place, so JVM will not have that much overhead to execute those methods. It can easily search those methods. So JVM will take less time. Hence, interface are slow when compared to abstract classes. Whatever we have discussed till now, that is as per Java 8. So interface can have only four kinds of things as per Java 8, that is constant variables, abstract methods, default methods and static methods. Default method and static methods were added for interface in Java 8 version. It was not there in Java 7. Okay. But as per Java 9 and later versions, an interface can have six kinds of things. These are constant variables, abstract methods, default methods, static methods, private methods, and private static methods. Here, private methods and private static methods are added for interface in Java 9. So, in Java 9, private method and private static methods are added. Okay, please keep in mind, while writing private methods in an interface, we should follow some rules. So these rules are, we should use private modifier to define these methods. We cannot use the combination of private and abstract modifiers because both have different meanings. The private method means fully implemented methods because subclasses cannot inherit and override these methods. But the abstract method means no implementation method in superclass. So here subclasses should inherit and override these methods. Okay, so that's why private method should have full implementation, means private method must contain body. Okay, and why we need private methods in interface, why it is introduced in Java 9? Because no need to write duplicate code, that is code reusability, and we can expose only our intended methods to the client or to the third party. Okay, got it. So I hope you understood the basic concept of interface, and I hope you enjoyed this video. So please like, share and subscribe this video. Thank you.